Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Microsoft's Devices Group has unveiled the Nokia 130, a mobile phone that costs just $25, but there's a big drawback. It lacks an internet connection and apps. With the 130, though, Microsoft is going after people in emerging markets who are buying their first phone. It's also a good fit for people who want a backup to complement their existing smartphones. Samsung launched its new Galaxy Alpha with a metal frame in a bid to boost sales after the plastic design of its smartphones has been blamed for the company's recent struggles. The phone runs Android 4.4 and is powered by an Exynos processor with four ARM cores. It has a 4.7-inch screen, 12-megapixel camera, and 2 gigs of RAM. We first showed you it a few weeks ago, and now the Scully AR1, a high-tech motorcycle helmet, is available for pre-order. The helmet is being sold on Indiegogo for $1,400 and is expected to ship in May 2015. The helmet features a heads-up display that shows a live feed from a nearly 180-degree rear-view camera. Google is joining forces with five Asian telecommunications firms to build and operate an underwater cable system from the US to Japan. It aims to support rising bandwidth usage and better link its data centers in other parts of the world. The optical fiber system, dubbed FASTER, will initially have a data capacity of 60 terabytes per second. Construction will begin immediately, with completion targeted for the second half of 2016, according to NEC. Using off-the-shelf components and specialized software, a tablet and depth-sensing camera can create a near real-time map of 3D space. The DPI 7 handheld scanner from Dot Product has a camera similar to a Microsoft Kinect sensor attached to an Android tablet running the company's software.
So one very good application for this is if I'm building something, I want to compare the as constructed with the design model and look for differences. Our data, our binary files go directly into Autodesk's recap application, and through ASCII formats go into other engineering applications.
One unique feature of the DPI 7 is that you can add information into an already existing 3D scan. For example, after scanning this kitchen, Greaves was able to add me and my camera in afterwards. He said at these distances, the product is accurate within a few millimeters, and the closer you get with the scanning, the higher the accuracy. The hardware and software bundle is available now for $5,000. If you've ever watched video of someone climbing a mountain or going for a bike ride, you know how boring they can get. Sure, they can be sped up, but you might end up getting sick watching it. Well, Microsoft Research has come up with a technology that it thinks might help. Called Hyperlapse, it aims to create a condensed time-lapse video that looks as smooth as the original recording. Hyperlapse looks at each frame in the video and tries to figure out the geometry of the world. Then it traces a smooth path through the world and stitches together multiple frames at a time to create new frames along this optimized path. The algorithm's creators say they are working hard on a Windows app so GoPro users can create their own videos. It's unclear how much the app will cost or what sort of local processing power it would require. You've probably noticed your social media feeds filled with people pouring buckets of ice water on their heads. It's in the name of raising awareness and funds for ALS, a deadly disease that slowly takes away voluntary muscle control. There's good news, though. Donations are four times what they were this time last year, and even some tech CEOs are getting into the challenge. You just saw Mark Zuckerberg accept the challenge from New Jersey Governor Chris Christie. Zuckerberg went on to challenge Bill Gates, Sheryl Sandberg, and Reed Hastings. Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella also participated.
No!
Nadella went on to challenge Amazon's Jeff Bezos and Google's Larry Page. Fun fact, no one has challenged me yet. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'm off next week, so Melissa will be filling in for me from San Francisco. As we head out, we'll leave you with some shots of flight deck operations from the USS George H.W. Bush in the Arabian Gulf. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.